Coming up next on ATETV, laser and photonics technology.
If you like science and math, it's just an exciting field to get into.
Geospatial technology.
Geospatial technology is taking known locations, attributes from the real world, and putting them on paper and making a map out of them.
And alternative energy technologies.
Our students are actually taking the used oil from the kitchen. They are producing biodiesel with that. We received enough funding then to convert our lawns equipment to operate on biodiesel.
Now on ATETV. Across the country to your own backyard, ATETV shows you the many advanced technological education opportunities available at your local community college. Did you ever want to know when all that math and science you learned in high school would come in handy? Well, just ask the students studying laser and photonics technology at Central Carolina Community College.
Nanometers. We have an infrared pushing out 950.59 nanometers.
If you're interested in lasers, focus on your math and sciences because those are the things that'll help you a lot in the laser fields.
This is the visible light here, and this is our reading at 496 nanometers. We'll jump down one more. There it goes there. They want to come into this field, and they know this is what they want, to stay on top of your math. You can do that, you can make it through the program with no problems. I think it's a good program for anybody to come into right now, especially with the economy like it is. It's a program that's gonna be here. You'll always be able to find a job.
If you like science and math, it's just an exciting field to get into. We give them a placement test. If they don't score enough to get into the program, they can take courses to increase their knowledges in whatever area in order to enter into the program, whether it's math developmental courses or English developmental classes. They have lenses, and they put all that together, beam splitters and polarizers and things like that.
We do a lot of math here. We take trig and trig functions, a lot of algebra. I like technology. I think it's cool. I have good math and science scores whenever I took my placement test, so that was a plus.
So when the diode isn't conducting, it's not taking away, is it?
It's a lot of equations and angles and a lot of theorems, so you need to make sure that you remember them and study them.
All right, half it, and we get 532 nanometers, okay? You have to have an understanding of science and an understanding of math entering into the program. I mean, we can start out at ground zero teaching, but it's a lot better if someone comes in with some background and back understanding.
It'll all pay off. If you're struggling with math in high school right now, if you just study hard and work through it, it'll all pay off. It's not going to disappear.
And now we've got this cool-looking blue light. So we're looking at 474.97 nanometers.
It seemed like if you climb it up clockwise, it would get stronger on both sides.
You think that you're never going to use it, but when you get into a field like this, you're going to need it.
Pushing out 950.59 nanometers.
Community colleges can help you get your math and science up to speed, and some even offer courses in laser and photonics technology that can prepare you for an exciting, high-tech, and high-paying career. Have you ever used a GPS device and wondered how all that information got in there? Let's meet Dave Nicholson, who's studying GIS, or Geographic Information Systems, at Central Piedmont Community College to find out more.
Hi, I'm Dave Nicholson, Central Piedmont Community College GIS program. We're going to collect some data on some manholes.
We get the GPS coordinates on a manhole, and we'll take that back and plot that, put that back into the database, and add that to a map, so now we have an actual known location where that manhole is.
And now I'm gonna click on the attribute button.
I got out of high school back in the 70s, ended up going to the Navy, and a fire control technician led me to commercial electronics. I was a two-way radio technician, worked for a paging company. I've been laid off a half a dozen times in it in that field, and it's time to do a career change, and this is what I chose.
Look at the manhole cover itself and see if you can see if it's stormwater, wastewater, AT&T, utility, whatever it is, add the attribute for that.
Geospatial technology is taking known locations and attributes from the real world and putting them on paper and making a map out of them.
Dave, you remember how to do it?
Face down.
Yep.
I've always enjoyed messing with maps. I'm in the ham radio and, you know, we got to look at the map, see where the guy is you're talking to, so it's just kind of evolved into that.
Scanning and geo-referencing and then loading the Trimble data.
I learned about the program at the Employment Security Commission. They had a sign up saying study GIS, and Central Piedmont had a good curriculum, so that's why I chose them. Well, right now I'm working on a couple of certificates, just C1 and C2 certificate, and I should have enough courses after these two semesters I've taken to have something by the end of this semester. Maybe an internship this summer, and then something that'll lead into a full-time position starting this fall. And enter the attributes of what I've got here. It says it's a sanitary sewer. A lot of these jobs are gonna be when you come knocking on their door and say, hey, here I am, they'll find something for you to do. Okay, I'm done.
Dave is really enjoying his time at community college, and he's on track for a hands-on internship and an exciting career. If GIS is something you may be interested in, be sure to check out your local community college. Alternative energy sources like solar, wind, and biodiesel are becoming more and more common, and the career opportunities in these fields are exploding. Let's see what Sinclair Community College is doing to prepare their students to meet the growing demand.
It's important that they understand, whether they go into this field or not, energy and its uses and the benefits of being responsible with it. The advancements have been many in the last couple of years, and prices have come down a lot for alternative energy. Windmills and solar panels and that sort of thing.
Biodiesel to replace regular diesel, ethanol to replace regular petroleum-based gasoline. Our students are actually taking the used oil from the kitchen. They are producing biodiesel with that. To use biodiesel, it has to meet a certain quality standard so that it will be used in equipment without damaging it. It became a real educational tool when they were able to test the biodiesel they were producing to make sure it was within the required standards, so it was able to be used in our equipment. We received enough funding then to convert our lawns equipment to operate on biodiesel. The students are learning how to process biodiesel, they're learning about alternative fuels, they are learning test procedures and those test requirements.
Work with the biodiesel, the solar energy, even hydrogen power for vehicles. I'm just glad that Sinclair is so on top of their game.
Are you interested in learning more about alternative energy technologies? Be sure to visit your local community college for programs they offer. And for more information on anything you've seen today, explore our website at ATETV.org. Thanks for watching.